growing up here, I had no special attachment to this place or to this land. What happened eventually, when I kind of caught the soil health bug, we realized, man, land regeneration may be one of the most valuable jobs that we have on Earth. Here's our system. Like, we're growing corn and we're growing soy and we're growing wheat. Now, how can we, on a large scale, impact a lot of acres? What Rob's doing is he's helping people learn how to do that in a way that has less environmental problems.
Regenerative agriculture is kind of a newer concept that brings together several ideas related to sustainability in farming and ranching. Here at the University of Missouri, we have one of the very first centers of regenerative agriculture in the country. You know, we were really fortunate last year to get the largest grant that the University of Missouri's ever gotten. It was $25 million from the U.S. Department of Agriculture, and it was through a new program they have to support climate smart practices. Soil health is a really key concept for regenerative agriculture, and what that's all about is the soil is an amazingly diverse community of organisms.
If the concept is how do we make the soil as healthy as possible, maybe it would be a better way of saying it. Maybe we're soil farmers. And then after that, then everything else falls in line. If you can get soil right, then your crops are more profitable. If you can get soil right, then your animals and everything are more healthy.
Josh Payne and his family have some really interesting things they're trying. So they had grown a lot of corn and soybeans on the farm, but Josh was really interested in adding some new enterprises and new approaches. So they have planted a lot of chestnut trees, they've planted hazelnuts, and then in between those trees, they're grazing typically sheep, but they also have some cattle they're grazing. They're using cover crop to both get more biodiversity that helps the soil, but also be more economical for those grazing systems.
Like, we're providing a benefit for the common good. Like, water is cleaner when it leaves our farm than when it got here. You know, air is cleaner here because of what we do and how we're doing this.
We all take it kind of for granted when we go to the grocery store that the shelves are going to be full and we're going to have all the food we need. But of course, in the reality of human history, that's not the case. We have these challenging times when food can be in short supply. And as we're facing more extreme weather, the more severe droughts, other types of storms that are causing problems for food production, we can't count as much on having that regular food supply as we did in the past. So that's why it's really important to add resiliency to our farming systems. And if we do that, then we go forward, we see these challenging weather conditions, we'll be better able to deal with that and maintain our food supply, and hopefully keep food affordable for everyone. Mm-hmm.